The film I would like to suggest is Charlie Chaplin's Modern Times from 1936. It's a classic and it shows, you know, the fragile work during the Great Depression and how people really had a difficult life then. And Charlie Chaplin is still the Trump and he takes on a factory work where he has to do assembly work. And, you know, you see him there working on the conveyor belt and he assembles stuff. And then all of a sudden, you know, his human side kicks in and he has to scratch himself and endures fly landing on his nose. And he has all sorts of problems and stops working. And then, you know, of course, it gets him into trouble with his neighbors who, you know, who are not happy with that. And, you know, and also that work really gets into him. And so even during breaks, he continues doing this movement and he even, you know, runs after women doing this. It's really funny. Until at the end he goes into, you know, a psychiatric clinic because he literally turns nuts. And so the reason why I chose this movie is because it really illustrates this beginning of scientific management, these ideas of Taylor and, you know, how you have to rationalize work. The whole idea is that this, you know, movement of scientific management was only possible because there is also a large innovation in how to study work. And that goes back to the Gilberts, who was a couple, who started to vid record the workers doing their work. In particular, they started with bricklaying and how they studied how, you know, when you do bricklaying, what kind of waste movements do you do? Do you take the brick and you put it up and you have to take the cement and so on. And so they studied these movements and they said, how can we organize work differently so they can be more efficient? And this is how we start our course in this reflection on how, you know, large innovations in how we organize work, this was the beginning of scientific management, were only possible because there was also an innovation in how to study work, in the methodology of how to study work. And this is, you know, I think very interesting, and we are looking at multiple methods in our course. Video is one of them, an innovative one still today. But we're also looking at more traditional ones like surveys or, you know, qualitative interviews or stuff like that. But I think it's really interesting, this notion that with different kind of methods, you will see organizations and their managerial approaches in different ways and you can learn different things.